Welcome back, adventurers, to the adventures of the Warrior Queens of the Mediterranean. And we have a new queen. At the end of the last episode, Queen Isabel II died. She had been infirm for a few years. And she actually lasted longer than I expected. But, yeah, at 70 years of age, she gave up the ghost, as they say. And we have her granddaughter, Konstantine. This is a bit of an intricate succession situation because Isabel II's first daughter actually was not of our dynasty. There was some problem with how we arranged the marriage. So I actually had Isabel divorce that guy and marry somebody else matrilineally, and she had daughters with that man, but her first daughter had her own children, and because I married her into our dynasty, they were actually children of our dynasty. That's how we ended up with this girl, Konstantine of the Mediterranean. And you can see Melissa, her mother, died at age 21, very tragically, in childbirth, the birth of her younger sister, Nikaeti. Her father then remarried and had another child, Vasiliki. And yeah, that's our situation right now. Konstantine is married. She has Alexios, a Greek guy we found. Not a genius, but intelligent, very good, and we have a genius son. Now, I just betrothed him to the princess of France, or a princess of France, to get an ally. And hopefully, Konstantine will have a daughter to continue the line of queens of the Mediterranean. We're still very young, so that is very possible to happen. We've actually rearranged a few things behind the scenes, so to say, because Nikaeti didn't get anything, which is, I think, is strange. If Konstantine is in the line and she's the first to inherit, then Nikaeti should have got something as well, so I gave her this bit. And then also Vasiliki, I decided to give her Athena and some other parts that belonged to the rebellious Greek counts that I took their counties from. Although upon succession, the rebellion war ended because they were distributed among various vassals. So it was suddenly over. Good for us. And we can redistribute these counties as our queen would have done anyway. All right. We also have a council, although some of the faces are the same. We have Duchess di Nicea as our court chaplain. And I'm not sure if we had Ephemia actually before here in this position. Evgenia as marshal, and we have decided to get Antipatra because whatever her name was, the spymaster before, didn't like us, and we found that to be too dangerous. So this is our situation. So we need to have a daughter. That means we should probably try and romance our husband. 100% chance. That is very nice. And immediately we have a declaration of love. The time has come to let my feelings towards Despot Alexios be known. I want him to remember this day for the rest of his life. Write a love poem. That is what I will do. The candle is burning low when I finally finish my poem. Before I send it, I give it one last read. Your luscious lips are the life-giving sun of my world. I wish only to hear your voice again, that I may know true joy, my darling Alexios. The waiting is unbearable. The thought of rejection makes me sick to my stomach. When his reply arrives, I tear the seal with shaking hands. While I cannot encourage you, my liege, I am most grateful for your kind words. Yours faithfully, Alexios. He won't resist my charm for long. Yeah. Also, I was very sneaky, and my father, who has been a source of joy and trouble for many years, I remarried him because we needed allies and we didn't have anyone of any significance. So I remarried him to Ursula von Polay, and her brother is now King of Italy. So now we have an alliance with Italy again, and we have France, right? Yes. Because of my son. So my father and my son have brought in the allies. And because my sisters have their own holdings, so that is not going to give us any allies. So we just need more children, I guess. Alright. We, Konstantini, we are cynical. We trust the self-interest of others above all else. So we're not very into the religion. We are very cynical about it. People have a lot of self-interest that motivates them. We are content, right? The Mediterranean realm is fine as it is. We do not see any reason to expand right now. I mean, there might be something that urges us, but we are content with our station in life. We're the queen. I mean, what else would you want? And we are sadistic. We enjoy to make others suffer. Which means we can use hostile schemes against our own children. Which is very bad, of course. It's very sinful in our religion as well. But it's part of who we are. We are astute intellectual. So we are very good at learning. We get a 30% bonus every month on our lifestyle experience. Learning lifestyle experience, that is. We are pretty energetic and a valued warlike culture. Now, our court... our court... is a warlike court. Right? With all this, we could go for an administrative court with building construction time bonuses, development growth, if we get to that level. And vassal tax contribution. We don't have the prestige to do that, but that is something we should probably consider, because yes, we are content, so we are not very likely to want to wage wars, although we might have to, and defensive wars, or if we get called in by our allies. But I think administrative makes more sense for who Konstantini is. And we want, yeah, to invest in building up our realm. We definitely are sticking with Greek. Our court amenities, now almost 6 gold per month. That's doable, right? This isn't too much. We could even up it a little, I guess. Is this the expected level? No, this is the expected level. Isn't it? Baseline 71. Maybe we should invest in this. It's just a bit more prestige. And here, guests are likely to stay long. That's not really, but complete inspiration quality. And less stress gain. That is good. Should we go for stylish? Yeah, I think she would like that. A young lady. would probably be into stylish fashion, especially if she just became queen. Yeah, my husband seems to like this. I think it's a little bit garish, but... to each his own, right? Alright. Should we hold court? Well, we don't have a lot of prestige. We might need that. So, let's wait a little. But yeah, look at her. Isn't she amazing? Alright. There we go. Scheme at court, and we also have a faction created against us. My spymaster has come to me with grave news. While we do not yet know who, someone is plotting to kill my courtier Ludovit. Who? Who is Ludovit? He is an old guy who is married to Mara Domagojevic, who is decent in learning, but I'm not sure why she's here. So why do you bother me with that? My kinswoman Adrini has given birth to a son, so she's in my court and of my dynasty, so we get to determine the name. She already has a Dorothea. Kalinikos, okay. And wait a moment, what's this faction? Greek Orthodox Populist, the County of Ionia. That's here, right? Yeah. That's now part of my sister's direct realm, so I'm not sure what we need with that. Wants independence from their liege. Yeah, but their liege is my sister. And this is an independence faction that I'm more worried about. Tunis. Okay. And, populists. Yeah, that's not a problem. Okay. You would make for an accomplished commander. Really? Another one of these. Yes, some mayors having some affair. Why is this in the news? I've concluded my task. She can no longer convert faith. Okay. So let's have a look at... no, not at culture, at faith. Yes, that's fine. Yeah, that is great. We were going down here, right? So, why don't we continue? Though here it's also good to have the delta, but... well, let's do this. As was our plan. And she's pregnant. What else do we have going on? So she's in Ionia, she's in Tunis, and she's in Alexandria. That's all good. We have an unhandled situation. A knight's declaration. As I pace toward my throne, I overhear Swanhild proclaiming something to my husband Alexius. That scrumptious man who charms me so, to which my fealty I eternally owe. For his life is my life, and our life to be. The beautiful star to a family tree. Is she reciting romantic poetry to my husband? Swanhilda, you are my rosa to the dungeon with you. She's one of my best knights. Alexis, get away from her, you pig. Or, courtly love, let that wonderful poetry echo through the halls. To the dungeon. That sounds not fair. And I wouldn't call my husband a pig. And there is no good option there. Okay, let's hold court then. Sitting on my throne, I gesture for my guards to open the doors of the hall. A stream of people following, some lining up in front of my throne, while others move out of the way so they can simply observe the proceedings. After several moments, all movement in the chamber has ceased. All faces turn towards mine expectantly. In front of me, I count three petitioners in an orderly row, waiting for me to call on them. Gesture for the first in line to approach. A shadow in the night. The man who approaches my throne is clearly a commoner. My lady, he begins his speech. I represent the local community of Panormos. Let me guess. Somebody is digging up dead bodies. Okay, now we have some other options here. Studying the human body is a sad necessity. Why didn't you invite me? Fresh living bodies make for better test subjects, and I imprison him. Ooh. But I spent 10 cord grander. Guards arrest the grave robber, or Kalila just cut it off. Save cemeteries. This is obviously the best option, but I am sadistic. But would I do this so openly? Probably not. Probably not. Why didn't you invite me? This is a bit not so good, but... Yeah, grave robbing is not a good idea. Just cut it off. Frontier Fracas. The next petitioner is evidently somewhat of a stranger in this court, as I do not recognize him. And the eyes of Marshal Yenia have been on them since they first entered. My lady, I have come to declare that the people of Aeolis are refusing to pay the taxes you have levied upon us. In times past, our land and people were granted rights and privileges which your recent exactions ignore. We request that you address our concerns fairly, or else imprison this wretch and crush the rabble. Maybe. Attract the ringleaders into an ambush. Intrigue challenge. Sounds to me like you may be misrepresenting some charters. Or give them what they want. No. I'm content but sadistic. I think I would trick them into an ambush. And they were ambushed and killed. Okay, then we have the Monster of Alexandria. A haggardly looking peasant now stands in front of me, my lady. I beg you for help. A monster prowls in the oasis of Alexandria, killing cattle and farmers alike. Few have seen it, but the mangled remains of its poor victims leave no doubt. It's clearly a huge wolf, as bloodthirsty as few have ever seen. Please, send your strongest hunters and save us from its voracious jaws. Take this gold. No, I shall fell the beast myself, or it sounds like a your problem. My prowess is excellent, in fact. Maybe I want the challenge? I mean, I do not want to waste 300 gold. Yeah, let's fill it ourselves. And that's it. My business here is done. I should go into intrigue too, I guess. Alright. Are we now hunting the wolf? Poetic license. There is no man lovelier than Despot Alexios. In his presence, my words often fail. I mean, look at that beard. And that stache. It's like, yes, I can totally understand. None of my compliments ever do him justice. Perhaps a carefully drafted poem would better capture his virtues. I will write about his noble righteousness, burning faith, exquisite features. Well, poetry is not my strong suit. His exquisite features. I was just pontificating about it. And he does not respond. What kind of monster is he? All the preparations completed, I set out with a select group of guards to face the infamous monster that is terrorizing Alexandria. It doesn't take us long to find it. A clear trail of blood leads us straight to the creature's abode. I was already informed of what to expect, but when the massive wolf finally stands in front of me, I can't help but shiver. Romanos died. Huh. Okay, I guess. I shiver. With the massive wolf. Face me, you foul beast. Oh, wow, that animal is larger than I expected, and I leave the village to fend for themselves. I would not live that down. Face me, you foul beast. And the monster is killed. Monster killed for 5 years. I gained some prestige, and I am now a novice hunter. Somebody is trying to kill another one of my guests. What's going on here? I hereby invite you to a feast at my court in Salerno. It will be a grand affair worthy of your honorable presence. This is my spy master and my aunt, although she's actually younger than me. Right? But yes, it will be my pleasure. A warm welcome. Every guest is gathered in the great hall, and our gracious host Dukesa Antipater has welcomed us all to the feast. I look forward to this. Yeah, we can go on. We don't need it. Unpleasant pleasantries. I am attending a dance in Panamos to spend some time with Despot Alexis. I thought I was attending a feast with my aunt. But who knows? The mere thought of touching hands make my heart jump. When I arrive, I find him stuck in a conversation with Mayor Ali of Banias. The miserable man drones on and on, totally oblivious to Alexius' discomfort. A little distraction seems appropriate. I'll take his place, no way. Enough, you are boring the Lord to death. I mean, he's not important to me. A little distraction seems appropriate. Urbana's changed the court language to Greek, and she is Hungarian. Okay, that's interesting. I have arrived in Panamos to pay homage to Lugur's Despotisa as a show of my loyalty. You have my word that I will do whatever it is you wish of me, my lady. Show her in. Zoe. Yeah, okay, you don't have that much money. You're forgiven. What is going on here? Ah, it's the Byzantines. Internal Byzantine matters. No, not even at that level. Easy star. Internal matter. Okay. Under the stone pine, in the scorching midday heat, they sit in the shadow under a great stone pine, playing on lutes and flutes. They sing in many tongues, yet my heart cannot understand. My heart can understand every word. I can hear them from my balcony, and they stir my soul. Yet I do not know the identity of these musicians, and when I leave my lofty halls and approach the tree, they are gone. Are they sent from heaven? Are they phantoms devised by Satan to ensnare me? Perhaps not, but what am I to do with these damned feelings? It's so beautiful. Awed by beauty? That's good. I should sponsor more musicians investing in music. Okay, or enough. I will have that damn tree chopped down. No, I think... Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on, but awed by beauty seems to be the right thing. Okay. Let us do that. My domain holdings. So, Panamos is our capital. Yeah. We can now construct... No, we can't. We don't have perks. Okay. There, yeah, these we can. Tax offices, leisure palaces, or royal reserves. This is extra development growth. That is very good. Yeah, I think we're going for this one here. Yo, it's only about 10. But, yeah. Here's the same as only... No, not even these. We're already constructing. Oh, we're still building the keep. Okay. What about Alexandria? Alexandria's lagging behind because I lost control over it again. But at least we have the Grand Cathedral. We're just not getting the full amount. Yeah. Caralis. We have that. Okay, so we can upgrade the mine. Let's do that. And that is all that we have money for right now. The rain is pouring down outside. My implacable, desperate Alexius sighs as he looks out the blurred window. How wretched Panamores can be. I wish I had someone to keep me company during long and dreary days. Is my beauty a cat person or a dog person, I wonder? I could say, fear not, I will always be by your side. Yeah. A loyal dog would make an excellent companion, or a clever cat would keep it happy. I think he's a dog person. But he's not. Okay. Well, a hut. No, we don't need a hut. Thank you. Intruder! Every time I close my eyes, I see Desperate Alexius' face. Sleep will not come. I cannot wait another moment. Cloaked in shadows, I make my way to the garden outside his living quarters. Are we not like living together? That's why I don't get pregnant. The sight of Alexius' chamber window makes my heart stutter, so close, yet so far. But wait, who is that climbing up the tower? The shady figure stops by Alexius' window and unlatches the shutters. My darling is in danger, I must save him. The sounds from the struggle above is the greatest motivator I have ever known. Without care for life or limb, I hoist myself through Desperate Alexius' window. I feel as if I have plunged into a frozen lake. Alexius is on the floor, the intruder pushing him down, a gleaming blade between them. With a roar, I grab the villain by the collar and throw her into the wall. The rest is a blur. When the danger is over, I turn towards him. Alexius, are you all right? I ask cautiously. As if my words were a spell, he finally unfreezes and throws himself into my arms. Thank God you are here, Konstantine. I will never let you get into harm's way again. I will never let you get into harm's way again. And I lay with him. Right there on the floor, I guess. We are now soulmates. Lovely. Do I have anything interesting on this side? I think we're good. Irini has grown up and put on that silly head wrap. Anyway, that's her business. Yeah, okay. Guardian can be assigned. I had a few others who needed guardians, right? So, give me a minute while I do that. Okay, that is taken care of. Several children needed guardians, a couple needed to get married, so I took care of that. And it is Valentine's Day, so I guess it's appropriate. And we have another one that has grown up, Ida de Nim, but she's wheezing. Yeah. Let's leave her to her own devices, then. That's the marriage is going through. Another child has grown up, so yeah, this one. Pescatore. He is my courtier, nothing special. Let's quickly find him someone. Yeah, with inheritable traits, something like that, not matrilineally. Why would Princess Anastasia want to marry some random? Okay, I mean, he is not lowborn, but still. Yeah, she is intelligent, and she is Amazonian. She's a guest somewhere. Well, let's get her. Oh, she is very fat. No. Her, I guess. One, the age of the world. I've been studying the ancient religious texts and the writings of scholars, and they all seem to agree that the world will end 6,000 years after its creation. By my calculations, we are less than a century away. However, my aunt, Duchess of Dionysia, urges me to keep it to myself. Leave it to the clergy and avoid panic. What if your calculations are wrong? Everyone deserves to know the truth, a reasonable point, or I should consult with more priests. I should consult with more priests, I guess. Ekaterina is no longer your court artificer. And we have a learning perk. Let's do that. Okay, I want this one. Cultural Fascination Progress. Yes. And we constructed a keep in Yerusalima. That is great. And we have some extra money. Let's see what else we can do here. Chevron. Yerusalima. There. So we need perks for those. If we want any of those, like archery grounds, we could do tax offices, leisure palaces, or royal reserves. Progress. Holding taxes plus 10%, that's quite nice. What else does this give us? Just extra taxes. And the Royal Reserves give us extra development growth. We're doing pretty well with taxes. But getting 30% more would be like 10 gold per month more right now. It's probably the development growth more that's going to be a bottleneck. Let's do this. We can now do another regiment, and we can, yeah, because we had, what was it? We had some kind of perk. Let's do another one of onagers. It's going to be a while before we get the innovation for the mangonels. So let's do that. Increase its size. Perfect. And then later we can expand our Nile archers. I would be delighted if your son and heir Nikitas would visit my court in Mahdia to meet his peers. Who are you? So Nazar of Tunis died in his sleep last year. And your father died after botched treatment several years ago. That is tragic. And now you, 11-year-old Nazar, are the Count of Mahdia. You don't like me. Yeah, I'm inviting everyone of note, which unfortunately includes him. I must decline. In fact, I should take your county. It seems you were playing some dangerous game there and got wounded for a moment. Pope Alexander becomes Orthodox protector. Okay. Staring at stars. From all my evenings watching stars, I've seen with my own eyes what I have only heard of before. The stars move at different speeds and reverse the course at different times, but seemingly in large groups. depending on which celestial sphere they belong to. Indeed, with the right calculations, one could even predict their movement. My art does not approve, of course. Leave the skies be. The celestial realm is for the clergy to know. I will find my answers in the heavens. Yeah, that's what I would do. Alright. Holy Order Spans, that is good. We can change it. Okay, we can ransom this Emir. He cannot afford a full ransom of 100, then he's staying. And another of my courtier. Somebody's trying to kill. Wait a moment here. A child has grown up. This one. Ooh, he's beautiful. Yes. Unfortunately, he's not very smart. But he is related to us. He's my cousin, in fact. Okay, let's find him a... No, not actually, really. Beautiful, if possible. Wife. We have several. Place to Toulouse. Okay, freedom and friendliness. Malik Abd al-Nur has been uncharacteristically friendly towards me lately. If this change of tone is indicative of a change of character, perhaps he could be convinced to release my acquaintance Razin from captivity. Surely, if he truly wants to be my friend. Despite all his pretense of friendliness, Malik has refused to release Razin. Do I... Oh, he's a renowned physician. He may be a sodomite, but there are other ways, my acquaintance. Yeah, maybe we can... ransom him? No. My friend Nabila died. 65. Okay, let's assign somebody for stewardship to this boy. Melissa Fania is good for a loving lock. I am engaging my dearest despot Alexis of the Mediterranean in our usual pillow talk, wrapping his lovely hair around my fingers. Do you love my hair so, my sweetness? Perhaps you should carry it with you always, as you go about your duties as despotisa, so that everyone will see you and I are one. I thought at first he was joking, but it quickly becomes apparent that he truly intends me to wear his hair as an accessory for all to see. I will wear it until I die. And I am now Konstantine with the lock. Okay. As long as it gives me a daughter, okay? Carnal comforts. Balin has been devastated ever since his wife Nabila died. Okay, he's Bulgarian. 53 years old. He hates my guts. I can't stand him either. He's a zealous Greek Orthodox. He comes to visit me one evening. I feel so lonely, he says, looking at me longingly. I remind myself that Nabila was my good friend. You've been so comforting, he says, biting his lips suggestively. Nabila was my friend. Yes, he may have been my friend, but he's not. I just want to feel something, he whispers, loosening the fastenings in the front of his shirt. Nabila was my friend. I'm sure that Nabila would not approve. Pull yourself together. Yeah. And now he really hates me, but no, that's like, come on. We didn't even like each other. What's got into you? I shall arrange a marriage for you, a matrilineal marriage. Yeah, somewhere far away, please. Maybe even... where is religion and not Mamaism? Huh? That doesn't seem to work. Because he's not even in my court. And of course everyone here is Mamaist, except for Martha de Poitiers. Demands conversion, yeah, definitely. Okay, she agrees, that's great. You are always there for me, and I hope you know that I am grateful. My son and heir Nikitas approaches me in a rare display of honesty. When I need it, I expect you to be there for me too. Or that is what it means to be a guardian. Let's be friends. The cooling of spear is low. It's only prowess plus 2. Do I really want to... To repair it for 38 gold. Not really. A child is growing in my womb. My husband, Despot Alexius, will be proud. Good. A sacred text. As I'm out for a stroll around the market, a merchant calls me over, insisting she has something that will pique my interest. The scent of drying herbs and foreign tinctures overwhelms my senses as I approach the stall. She's rifling through a collection of dusty tomes and other treasures. After some digging, the merchant produces an old book and insists I need it for what is to come. Fine, I'll buy it. Perhaps we can come to an agreement. I'll take what I need. Or what need do I have for your books? I don't want to spend that much, but it's a book artifact, yeah. I am sadistic and I am the queen. I'll take what I need. Charting the human body, we already have a copy of this, don't we? A bibliomancy. As I'm putting away my newly acquired charting the human body, a slip of parchment falls out. Upon it are instructions for a practice called bibliomancy, where one might divine their fortune from a passage in a book. All I need to do is open this text to a random spot and read the first fateful verse my eyes might fall upon. The temptation is overwhelming, or I'll have nothing to do with this unholy practice. It's not so much temptation, we are cynical, right? I might gain a learning lifestyle perk, or I'll have nothing to do with this unholy practice. The fact that it's unholy doesn't matter to us. I think, I will just want to see. I mean, this lady said it was important. Is there anything to it? I don't think so, but who knows? I follow the instructions to the letter and select a passage at random from the text before me. Shivering with anticipation, I open my eyes and read. Fear is the mind killer. A coward dies a thousand tiny deaths, yet a valiant man dies but once. What am I to make of this? Fear is the little death that brings total obliteration. Fascinating. This requires further research. Yeah. I have finally cracked the mysterious passage from charting the human body and feel much wiser for it. Thanks to that merchant, the threads of fate suddenly appear more clearly to me. Fear may well be the mind killer, but I have faced my fear. Without fear, I die but once. And I have another perk. And there's an alliance proposal. Okay, so... maybe this. Which reminds me, we might benefit from learning some languages. Ekaterina Militi? Sure. And an alliance with, who are you? The Tulunid Empire, Emirate. Tulunid. You're just this, really? Forget it. Don't waste my time. What languages do we speak? Only Greek, it appears. Yeah. And, well, that's his language too. That is great. We should learn some other languages. Who else is in my court? Bavarian, Anglo-Saxon, Croatian, Galician. That might actually be useful. French, definitely. Let's do that. Learn language. Okay. And we have a thing at court. And a new artifact. What was it that we got? Oh yeah, charting a human body. Yeah, we have already displayed it. And there is another one. So learning plus one, small health boost. 5%. This one is actually better. This is a better copy of that. Yeah. Alright. Well, on that note, let us end this episode. Thank you for watching. Please hit that like button. And I'll see you again in the next episode for more adventures of our dear Konstantine, the Queen of the Mediterranean.